I mean, when I was 16, 17, I remember I walked several times, but one particular time it sticks in my mind, this girl that I think I mentioned, no, I mentioned in True Life, this prostitute I knew who had gotten pregnant. She wanted, and it wasn't my child, but I took her to an abortion clinic, and this big fat white guy, probably 45, 50 years old, they had blood on these little fucking Barbie dolls or whatever the fuck they had. And he comes yelling, screaming, and I wanted to douse her with the ketchup. And I fucking took my foot and fucking kicked him down 5 or 6 stairs. And this is one of the things is that, well, we're getting off. The people on the liberal side or the progressive side, they don't have the balls to stand up for their rights. And one of the reasons that we're going to probably lose the right to an abortion through the Supreme Court, although I think that'll fire people up, that within a year or two, most states will have amendments and get it back, the right to abortion, is because people, you have to fight in this life for what is right and for what you consider rights, because there will always be people that will try to take things away from you. Always be people that will try to limit things to only their group, and it's a nonstop battle. Now, hopefully, in these eons and centuries that I mentioned in this passage, most dead white male types who are still breathing but are dead inside will finally realize that women, you know, should and deserve to be treated equally, not because it's chivalrous, but because they exist and they're thinking beings. But these people are the same people who don't see women as equals. They don't see non-white males as equals. They don't see if you prefer to suck a dick rather than lick a pussy, they don't see you as equal. And it's just nonsense. But there I go again.
No, I feel what you mean. I guess my only point about that, I understand the political part of it, but also the when I said pissing people off, I mean you're rocking the boat if you're doing something good with anything in art, or you know, if you're doing a really good job of work,
because
you might be from the level.
it inspires jealousy. And you've probably seen, I've written about what I call the divine inspiration fallacy. Have you ever seen that?
Right, I know,
Because
yeah.
people think, oh, and this gets back to free will. You know, the Lord or some force out there. It just came to me. Even in looking up Robinson Jefferson and stuff, there's a lot of talk about it just came to me or something. No, your mind concocts it. It is all a part of you. There is no divine inspiration. It is all a part of you. That is what you are. And even if it comes to you on a subconscious or unconscious level, whichever term you prefer, it is still you. Your mind is still tilling that soil, whether you recognize it or not. You are the author. It doesn't come to you. No one is just going to automatically, be in a zombie state where they're doing automatic writing or they're painting. And no one's going to paint a fucking masterpiece like Rembrandt just because, oh, I've been Shiva has taken my body and now I can't control my hand. And oh, there it is. I painted a Rembrandt type masterpiece. It doesn't happen that way.